is here in this second round match. Kathy Marshall trailing Annette McBride 20-5. We've made this event harder for the gladiators. We're going to give the contenders a 15-second head start now. A look at Annette, and she'll be followed by Diamond. Diamond with an excellent record. Kathy Marshall will be pursued by Siren. Siren has yet to lose in this event. She has pulled off every contender she has met.
That's very good at the wall. This 15-second lead is really going to help her tremendously. And I think her secret is that she doesn't really plot it out. She just more or less attacks the wall. And that's what the real champions do.
She does some rock climbing back in Boise, Idaho. And here come the gladiators chasing after Kathy Marshall. Is Siren in pursuit of Annette McBride is Diamond right now. Right now is Kathy Marshall, who was unsuccessful in her preliminary wall attempt. Again, the first contender up there will get 10 points, and it's going to be Kathy Marshall. If Annette can make it, she'll pick up 5. 20 seconds left on the clock. And look at here. The Daily Double.
Absolutely. Both our contenders doing an excellent job. And you can see just what that extra 5-second head start means. Look at the leads Annette and Kathy have on our gladiators. I gotta be honest with you, I don't think a 10-second head start would have made any difference. These two girls move like experienced mountain climbers. Kathy hoisting herself up there for 10 points. Annette right behind her. She grabs the top. Watch her hoist herself here. Picks up 5.
So let's see if the head start advantage works for the man. A look at Joe Kettle, who's desperately in need of points. He'll be followed up by Turbo. Joe has been overpowered in some of the more physical events, but in the technical events, he should be good. Like the wall, and here he is at home back in his Oakland area practicing in one of those indoor walls.
15 seconds.
It's real deal right there. That's the key right there. I'll let him know that one.
And indeed, Ted LePage will be looking over his shoulder because Viper will be in pursuit of him. Joe Kettle equipped with climbing shoes.
Look at Ted. Doing very well.
Joe Kettle just 158 pounds, so the forces of gravity much more benign to him than they are to a man who weighs 200. Ted's weight. They're looking good. And what, Larry, they're looking great.
That's the highest I've ever seen Ted on the wall.
30 seconds left. Joe Kettle up and over. He gets to 10. Ted LePage may get to 5 because he's up there too. Bingo. The contenders have done it.
All that practice paid off for Joe Kettle. Check this out. No wasted motion. Every movement counts. Not only does he maintain his balance and grip, but he's fast about it. Looks just like he did on his video. Ted, on the other hand, carrying that extra 20 pounds, well, that makes a difference.
This is the Tower of Power. Contenders, you better be ready for Powerball, because you know I am. Take a look at those guns.